13. They're sitting in 7th.
Has been a permanent fixture on the Formula One calendar for over 30 years now, and for good reason. Do you remember Michael Schumacher's absolute dominance here in that rain-soaked Grand Prix in 1996? That day, he took his first ever victory for Ferrari, and we've had many more iconic moments since. It's a sellout crowd of 140,000 here today as we await lights out for the 730-meter sprint down into Turn 1. This is a 2.9-mile racetrack. Overtaking is challenging through the 16 corners, but there's still a lot of high-speed excitement to be found, including the flat-out Turn 3 and the terrifying blind right of Turn 9. It's time to see how our drivers are stacking up after yesterday's exciting qualifying session. What a qualifying yesterday for George Russell. He'll start today's race from pole position, edging out Max Verstappen, who'll start from P2. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Bottas, Fernando Alonso, Esteban Ocon, and Joe, Gasly, Tsunoda, Stroll, and Alex Albon, Leclerc, Sainz, and Sir Lewis Hamilton, and Magnussen, Ricciardo, Moore, Sebastian Vettel, and Sergio Perez, Norris, and Nicholas Latifi. Now it's almost time for lights out, so let's go down to the track. Natalie Pinkham joins me once again in the commentary box. It's fantastic to have you with us today. I'm curious though, how do you think the drivers stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, I imagine they'll be starting to feel the adrenaline as they anticipate the rundown into Turn 1, a bit like preparing to go into battle. The unknown situation will bring nerves, but that's a good thing. It'll keep them focused on the moment and on their surroundings as we build towards the start of the Grand Prix.
Okay, good parking there, mate. Now we need to make sure we get a... issue. We're currently investigating. Find somewhere to retire as soon as possible. We can't risk you carrying on with this race, I'm afraid. I repeat, find somewhere to retire the car immediately. It's too dangerous to stay on track.
Then, which has paid off in spades, a great victory here at the Spanish Grand Prix. Natalie Pinkham, how do you think they were able to set themselves apart today?
Well, they certainly stood out as a driver with tons of confidence on the track. I think their ability to keep their cool, even during some of the more hectic parts of the race, meant they were able to capitalise on the mistakes of other drivers, giving them the opportunity to make their way to the top spot with ease.
The drivers are en route to the podium as we speak. What a fantastic win for the Red Bull team. They performed exceptionally today, keeping us firmly on the edge of our seats throughout the entirety of the race. Congratulations to everybody at the team. Drivers' Championship. Let's focus on the driver of the day. Natalie Pinkham, come on, who do you pick?
Well, you can't fault anything that Sergio Perez did out on track today. He drove flawlessly, making him an easy pick.
Let's move on to the constructors. And pulling further ahead in the standings, it's Red Bull. Meanwhile, good work from Aston Martin this weekend, who pushed themselves further up the order. It's been an absolutely wild weekend of Formula One action, and I can't wait to see what's next.
We had a major issue on the production line earlier this week, so the entire development package for the weekend has failed. Any redevelopments will need to be ordered from the R&D screen,